enthusiasts. Now, the market for buying leather watch straps is often quite confusing, because there's everything from the Amazon relatively cheap straps that you often see being sold with very low quality leather and fixtures, all the way up to the straps being sold for £200 or £300, which are extremely high quality but simply unattainable for the vast majority of us. And generally in that £50 to £150 mark for straps, one finds a lot of off-the-shelf straps which are perhaps very well made, but don't offer anything like the customization that you would be able to access at the higher price ranges. And this is why I was quite interested when Finwatch Straps contacted me. And this is a brand which is quite different to other strap manufacturers which have contacted me in the past, and which I've had to turn down because I simply wasn't pleased with the quality of the straps once I'd received them. And this is often something I find with straps, that one is often confronted by a lot of straps which aren't as high quality as one would want, and as a result it makes selections quite difficult when it comes to choosing. And so in this case, I was impressed to find a manufacturer which truly made handmade straps for a price which was remarkably reasonable and attainable for someone of, for example, my position in terms of buying watches. And so I was contacted by them in order to review their straps. And so I'd like to be completely clear about that I didn't buy these straps, they were sent to me, and indeed made to my specifications. And likewise, I have been sent straps before, which have been made for me in similar ways, which I've simply sent back, because I wasn't pleased with the way they were made. And so as a result, I thought they didn't fit with regards to recommending to my viewers. However, I'm pleased to say that I've found a strap manufacturer for leather straps specifically, which I can really recommend to my viewers. Because I have been asked this question over the holidays, over the Christmas holidays, in fact, quite a lot, and I was unable to give a clear answer just because of this problem. And so these straps are made in Helsinki, and as a result, not in the usual styles of American tanneries, for example, or Italian tanneries, which tend to be the two major ones, with Paris also being a hub of leather goods. And so I was quite interested to see what they were able to manufacture, because these are completely handmade. And handmade is a term which is often tossed around and I think has various meanings depending upon who you ask. Some follow the lines of, for example, Hermès, who hand finish their products, which I personally think is a tad misleading and unfair on the buyer, because something which is manufactured in some far-fetched country at a very low price and then finished by someone in Europe simply doesn't seem an honest way of selling something. However, here you're really able to get something which is truly of a quality and of a lucidity in terms of providing you with all the information you may want about these straps, which I appreciate. And talking about the straps themselves on my Zin 104, which I feel is rather appropriate, as a Helmut Zin died just this week, which is really a loss to the watchmaking world in terms of someone who really changed the way we looked at pilot's watches. So a really appropriate choice, I felt, for today. But these straps are in this case, the Chromexcel Burgundy No. 8. And Chromexcel is a type of leather which provides you with this very soft surface, which is remarkably shiny and flat and uniform for handmade leather. And these are unlined leather straps, you can see, so they're woven together in a way which is far more simple, you could say, than a backed, fully finished leather strap. But in terms of the manufacturing, these are cut by hand, so cut from a single piece of leather with a blade, then folded over, scored, beveled, and woven all by hand, which is something I appreciate, because it does mean that this hasn't been machine touched or adjusted from production to wearing the strap, which is great to see, because one does often have these problems with regards to manufacturing, and so as a result, a lot of brands outsource their straps. And as a result, if you ask questions about them, they know very little about the manufacturing, which is again something I appreciate about these straps. In terms of the customization provided for a price of between €40 and €90, which is actually extremely reasonable when you consider that you can have custom straps made for well over £200 into the £300 mark if you really want something completely handmade. And in terms of options, you have various types of leather from Chromexcel's to for example, the Phantom brown and black models they have, which are also waterproof, which, incidentally, the one on my Tudor is. And in terms of this, they're able to also provide sizing, because these are completely handmade, from 27 to 16 millimetres, so everything from a very large Panerai down to something like a small dress watch, which is, again, fantastic to see, because one often is kept to the sizes of 18, 20 and 22 millimetres, when actually a lot of watches have 19 and 21 millimetre size lugs, which as a result are far more difficult to find straps for. And the quality of the leather here is extremely good, and of course is something which changes depending on which type you choose, bearing in mind that, that leather is something which is by no means uniform, and I feel actually shouldn't be uniform, and is a tad questionable when each strap comes out looking identical, especially when it's such a soft style of finishing. And the colours are relatively subtle and difficult to show in this light, but as you can see, this is a burgundy with this yellow stitching, and then this Panerai style leather strap with a single keeper. But alongside that, you can get tapered models as well, such as this Phantom Brown waterproof, seen on my Tudor Heritage Ranger, which I thought fitted rather well in terms of that slightly distressed and robust and rugged look which this watch, I feel, conveys. And this is a very different style of leather, as you can see. It's much softer, and the finishing of these straps is far more rough in terms of providing a distressed sort of look. So as you can see, this is a rather distressed look to the leather. And as a result, the backing is also this very soft inner side, which provides this suede finish, which is very, very comfortable against the skin. And as you can see, they are very, very supple. And this is an interesting comparison to, for example, the standard stock strap that you get on the Tudor Heritage Ranger, which is quite a hard, extremely high quality, granted, strap from Tudor, which is backed with a velvet style of finishing. But in truth, I ended up swapping this strap out for various others after merely a week of wearing it, just because I was tired of the fact that it was a very hard strap, and so as a result was less than comfortable for long periods of time. Whereas by contrast, this is extremely soft leather, but still, due to the fact that it hasn't been treated to death, is extremely robust, and actually very, very comfortable on the wrist. As you can see, it wraps around the wrist very nicely. And what this provides one is a very, very good fit, since these are custom made for the length of the strap you need in terms of your wrist size. So my wrists are the exact size of these straps, which is great to see in terms of being able to have a strap which fits perfectly without too much overhang, which is often a problem when one sees the strap extending up over the side of the arm, which again can look inelegant and in many ways can catch on cuffs and make a strap more difficult to wear and inconvenient. And of course, I have gone for more distressed styles here, as you can see, but blacks, for example, are available for a more subdued look. And it is worth noting, of course, the manufacturing process of these straps is very, very traditional. They are very much cut from a single piece of leather, as you can see from these photos and videos, and then woven and produced, really, to the specifications you want, which is something I can't stress enough, because I've had a lot of problems with straps in the past, being manufactured in ways which are below what you would expect for the price one's paying for these sorts of straps, and certainly for the price one is paying for this sort of strap in this higher quality of leather, and this very soft finish of leather. You are able to really have exactly what you would look for and what you would want. One other benefit of going for a strap of this sort of quality rather than a far more simple quality of strap, or indeed a strap which is very highly finished, is the fact that because these styles of leather are relatively damaged by the tanning process and remain extremely soft and very nicely finished, you can actually apply waxes and oils to them over the years to stop them from cracking, and indeed to keep them resistant to water, and indeed to reduce the damage of sweat, for example, to the inside of the strap. Because you can see, these are unlined, as I've said, which means that they do pick up damage as time goes on and develop a patina, which also has its benefits in terms of providing something a bit different and somewhat unique to each individual strap. But in terms of the finish itself, you will be able to maintain this like a pair of shoes, for instance, over the years by applying an ointment or balm to it in order to maintain that finish and the comfort on the wrist. And of course, the thickness of the leather also is maintained by this, which is something which is highly underrated, because often one wears very large watches on thin straps, which can be less comfortable than if you wear a strap which is significantly sized and thick. Because as you can see, a strap which is of this sort of thickness enables a watch to remain very balanced on the wrist, which prevents any sort of slippage or movement, despite the fact the strap doesn't actually have to be tight at all, it can be loose on the wrist. And this is highly underrated, because there are a lot of problems with regards to thinner straps, notably the fact that it's far easier to bump a watch, because the watch will be moving about, and likewise a watch always feels larger if it's on a slimmer solid style of strap, which is why often very small dress watches, I often recommend wearing them on something like a highly tapered strap like this one down 16mm, because it will make the wear more comfortable on the wrist, as it makes the watch feel larger and heavier, despite its mass remaining exactly the same. Now, of course, there are a few aspects of these straps which I think one has to consider, due to the fact that they will make wearing these straps on smaller watches quite difficult. And the reason for this is that you have to have a watch with a relatively long distance between the spring bar and the case. And I don't mean an enormous distance, but a watch with the spring bars very close to the case may be difficult to fit the strap. And the reason why I say this is I tried to fit this to one of my watches, which happens to have quite a close spring bar to the case, and I ended up cutting into the strap with the case as a result of that difficulty. Likewise, the fixtures and the measurements aren't exactly as precise as they would be in an industrially made strap. And this is seen in, for example, the gap between the top and bottom of the strap where the spring bar sits does vary in terms of its length, which means that it's easier to put the straps in this way as opposed to flat, because it means you can very carefully slot the spring bar in, which are a few things which one has to get used to, which are different to normally woven straps, where they're woven down their length and then across. And this is something that you just have to get to grips with, really, when wearing one of these straps, as opposed to a genuine problem. But rather are aspects which I think it would be nice to see in future straps with tighter tolerances around the spring bars, because it does make using these straps just that little bit easier and that little bit less difficult on a daily basis if you're changing the straps regularly. But then it's extremely difficult to argue with a strap which costs only €40, yet offers you a truly customisable and a genuinely bespoke service in terms of producing something that is genuinely to your specification, to your measurements, indeed to your exact choice in terms of finishing, in terms of the fixtures, as far as the keepers go, and then as far as the buckle goes. So you really are getting something which is personal, which is something I do genuinely appreciate from a source which you can trust, you can ask questions to. And so I have included a link down below with regards to taking a look if you'd like to and you're interested on the market for some of these straps, because this really is a manufacturer I can recommend, having tried their straps, with a comfort which I haven't found elsewhere, in terms of being genuinely supple, but also durable and robust for daily use, in a way which is often not seen, because these things don't tend to go hand in hand, where very soft straps aren't resilient, but very very resilient straps aren't very comfortable. And this offers you something rather nice in between, which I haven't been able to find a competitor for, and which I'm very pleased to be able to say I've been able to review. And so I'll conclude the video here, but I would like to hear your opinions in the comments down below with regards to your thoughts on custom straps, and what your particular requirements are, and also as to where you stand with regards to strap pricing. Because I personally find that I just can't justify spending over £100, for example, on a strap. And so as a result, I am extremely interested in straps which are produced to high quality, which cost significantly below that price. But I am interested to hear what you think of that, with regards to the pricing of your straps and indeed where you stand in terms of the quality to price ratio. And if you did enjoy the video, then please do like, share and subscribe to help the channel and to be able to enjoy more content here in future. So thank you very much for watching. This is Armin the Watch Guy, over and out.